Hey guys, so I brought y'all along with me to slay this wig. Side part, natural, no baby hairs, getting grown and sexy. And we're using Erica J.
Girl, look at that.
You know you a bad bitch, classy nails, French tip. These bitches can't sit with you, white toes for the hoe. Chanel bag off the Chanel swag, I swear I'm feeling you. You ain't just choo-choo getting money too, I'm finna trick off. Baby, know you fine, don't you? Baby, know you fine.
Welcome back, Major Babes. We are here with another vibe. And hello, hi, how are you? To all of my new babes that are coming in. So this is the wig that we're dealing with today. The link will be in the description box below. I did not order this wig, my client did. It came pre-plucked, I do believe, but I still plucked it anyway, and I also bleached it using 40 volume developer, and I let it sit for maybe 15 to 30 minutes. Yeah, I did her breakdown while it sat. Here is just me applying color match makeup to the inside of my client's wig. I went ahead and cut off her ear tabs, plucked and bleached this wig off camera. I also did her ball cap method off camera. So if you want to see those in details, just let me know and I will get those to y'all. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So this is just me applying the same color to her wig cap. It's just I'm using the concealer now instead of the powder because I had ran out or whatever. Once I finish applying her makeup, I just go through and clean up the area with some alcohol before I apply my gluing things, right? Yeah, you gotta make sure the area is clean so the glue can have something to stick to. Today we are using Miss Erica J's Hold Me Down adhesive and skin guard. This is the watermelon scented one. She has an original, she has a sport, and then she has a watermelon. I've used these already. I love the products, love how they smell, love how they work, period. So first you apply the skin guard, you let that dry, and then you go in with the glue. So it is directed for you to use a certain amount of layers depending on how long you want the style to last. I try to give my clients the longest, time frame, I guess you could say, as possible before coming in for a maintenance or whatever. So I apply anywhere between 5 to 7 thin layers because that's what it says you're supposed to do. And it does hold, the whole 2 weeks. I've had a client that has went maybe 2.5 without a maintenance in between. So yeah, it Hold Me Down most definitely does what it's supposed to do. It does what it says it's supposed to do. I guess a few pros and cons about it. I wouldn't necessarily say I have cons, but I guess, a beginner con would be this glue dries very quickly, like compared to like Ghost Bond or something like that. This dries very quickly, so you have to make sure, like, once you apply your glue and spread it out real thin, because you're supposed to use thin layers, make sure you're watching that glue, because it can go from okay, just dry it clear, ready for my next layer, or ready for you to apply the wig, to oh, I'm clear and I'm dry and not sticking no more. You know what I'm saying? So that time frame is very quick, so you have to watch it. If you don't watch it, you will mess it up. I'm telling y'all from experience because I done did it. Don't wait too long. Once it dry clear, you either need to go ahead and add your next layer or go ahead and put your wig on, baby. And there's a reason why I said that that was a beginner con, because for people who are used to using glues and things like that, this will be really good, you know, especially stylists who have, you know, multiple clients a day. You don't have to really wait all day for the glue to dry. You know, you can get them in, get them out, bookies. Like, yeah, period. Also with this glue, it gives a watermelon hookah type smell to it. You know, I don't have a problem with it. My clients are having a problem with it. So, you know, if that's something, you know, you need to go based off of, then yeah, be my guest. The glue does dry. Like, it has a green tint to it. I'm not sure if that's just how her glue dries all together, or if, you know, that's because of the watermelon scent. But I think it's because of the watermelon scent. Okay, people. Yes, I know. It skipped a step. So, when I guess I didn't hit record. I don't know. I popped the camera up, press record, had it going, you know, had it up close and personal so y'all could see me applying this lace. And I go back to look at it and the footage going, like, what in the actual, what? Like, what? That blew me. But anyway, I'll get y'all another, you know, one of those. But this is just me styling her. We went for a no baby hair natural side part curl type of look, and I did it with my flat irons, you know, shout out to Baby Blitz. So this is just a closer shot of how I actually curl the hair with the flat iron, because a lot of people don't know how to curl with the flat iron. Sometimes I curl with a flat iron, sometimes I don't. It just depends on, you know, what I have available to me. So I'm getting my flat irons. I'm going to turn them towards me while flipping the tail of the hair, right? And I'm gonna pull up, and I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna turn, flip the tail, and pull up. You don't want to do this too tight, because if you do it too tight, your flat iron is not gonna be able to rotate, you know what I'm saying? So you gotta give yourself some slack, but not to where it's too loose, to where the hair is not getting heated and curled by the flat iron. You know what I'm saying? Do that make sense? Oh, it makes sense. But I'm gonna do this one more time, and I'm gonna slow it down for you so y'all can really see. Also, make sure that when you're clipping your curl, you're clipping through the inside of the curl. That way you're not leaving an indention on top of the curl stem, is what it's called. Yeah, because that's gonna, yeah, don't do that. But here we are. I'm gonna rotate it real slow, flip that tail, rotate it, flip that tail. Make sure you're flipping the tail now. Okay, you see me had to go back. Ooh, do turn and flip. Make sure you're keeping control of that tail and you're flipping that tail as you go, because if not, that's another reason for your flat iron to get stuck and get caught, because the hair is getting tangled within itself. You know, just help yourself go easier. It makes it more effective. Turn and flip that tail. Don't forget that tail, baby, okay? All right. Also, a great clip for you to use would be the duckbill. It gives you a lot of more room to hold your curls. I like to use the duck bills to hold my curls. That's just my preference. You know, do what works for you. But I feel like the duck bill clips are just easier to work with when pinning up curls all together. Okay, slow-mo time, right? So we're going to go in, and we're going to curl. We'll turn our flat irons toward us. If you want your curls to come toward you, you're going to come toward you. If you want them to go away from you, you're going to go away from you, right? So you're going to turn it, and you're going to rotate that tail with it, right? Turn and rotate. But you got to make sure you're rotating that tail as well. All you're doing is just repeating that. You're gonna rotate it, about half a turn. It's not a complete 360, about half a turn. You're gonna slide it away from the head, rotate again. Slide it away from the head, rotate again. Once you're at the end, you're going to roll it back down, hold it for maybe 5 to 10 seconds or until you feel the heat on the outside, and then release and pin it. That's all you're gonna do, baby. That's all. When you bring it out, like once you hit the end, you don't want to pull it all the way through to where you run out of hair and the flat iron has nothing else to hold to, because you're not going to be able to roll it back up to let it sit if it's out of hair. If all the tail is gone, that makes sense? I hope that makes sense. Like, let me go back. Okay, so we're going to do another slow-mo. Ready? Boom. Okay, so you see how this tail, you see how it still got a little bit left? And then I rotate it down like it's not all the way gone type thing. Yeah, you want to keep it there so your flat iron has something to hold on to. Because if you pull it all the way through, your curl's going to pop out. And you're going to have to start the curl over again like how I had to do maybe like a minute or so ago. Yeah. Now, disclaimer. I am not telling y'all to keep an inch, half an inch, a whole finger's length worth of hair out at the end of the curl. Because y'all ain't finna be in the comments busting, oh my God, my curl got a hook on the end, it's fish hooking or whatever, whatever. No, baby, because that's not what I said. You want to bring it all the way through to where it's as small as possible, but it's not giving that curl with a straight end type look. It's not giving that beach wave type of look. It's not giving that fish hook type of look. You know what I'm saying? You just have to do it to understand. You get it? Get it. But this is the pin up. Period. She's looking cute. And you're going to let those curls sit pinned up until they are completely cooled. Completely cool. Do you hear me? Okay. And here we just have me defining her part, you know, plucking out those extra hairs, defining it with some concealer, the concealer that I use for a ball cap. Yeah, that one. We're going to define it with the concealer, and then we're going to go in with some black spray and a curved comb to go ahead and define that little side part we got going on. Yeah.
Taking these drugs, I'm gonna be up until the morning. It ain't your car, you just a Lisa, you don't own it. If I'm in the club, I got that 5 when I perform. farm in the back end, just came in and out corners. Vibes a little cute, they all on us. I'm from Atlanta where young niggas run shit. I know they hating on me, but I don't read comments. Whenever I tell her to come, she coming. Whenever it's smoke, we ain't running. Too hard, don't stay too close. You gon' walk around the town. Off this way, doing all these shows. Coming on the road, I don't care where I go. Long as I hit big, bad little vibe. Shipping on my mind. Soon as I get back, shit and shit. Do this all the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie get made. Too hard, don't stay too close. You gon' walk around the town. Off this way, doing all these shows. Coming on the road, I don't care where I go. Long as I hit big, bad little vibe. Shipping on my mind. Soon as I get back, shit and shit.
Every other night, another dollar getting made. Every other night started with a good day. I feel like a child, I got boogers in the face. I'm investing in the dollar, this shit is a parade. I don't want your train, I'm going out of slave. I had that draw that too many bitches getting saved.
But can we get into these curls? Can we get into this bounce? Can we get into this juice? Like, what? Alright. So I'm gonna spray it with a little bit of spritz, a little pump it up, you know, just kind of keep the curls in their shape. Don't want to use too much because it's gonna make it crunchy. And then this is the what is it called, the Sheen spray, olive oil type spray. I love that, y'all. Like, oh my god, it smells so good. And I just scrunch all that up in the hair, you know, make sure everything got everything. Yeah. And here we have our final look. Isn't she pretty? Isn't she gorgeous? Like, what is it giving? Tell me what it's, let me know what it's giving in the comments. Giving me? Period. So I'm just, you know, fixing a couple touch-ups, you know, just getting it to my liking, trying to fix the swoop to how I want it. Ooh, I can't talk tonight. What's going on? But this is what we ended up with. My client was satisfied. I was satisfied. One of my friends who stopped by to see what I was doing was also satisfied. So yeah, it's just a win-win all around. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe so y'all don't miss a vibe. If y'all want that plucking tutorial, ball cap tutorial, and if y'all want to see me actually, you know, install the wig, like put the lace to the glue, because obviously I didn't film that, let me know down below and I will get those to y'all as soon as possible. You feel me? Yeah. Also, don't forget to check the description box down below for that link for the Erica J products and for the link for this wig. Yeah. Bye, babes. Mwah, mwah.